Georgia, man.
Hello and welcome back, beautiful people. I just want to thank y'all so much for tuning into my channel and deciding to watch me. Like, I am honored. I didn't think that I would have as many subscribers as I have. I know I have a way to go. I've gotten a significant amount of views and everything, and it is all thanks to you guys. So I just wanted to take this second out to say thank you so much for watching my channel. So let me talk about what y'all are here for. So you guys, here's the thing. I wear makeup literally every day. Like, this past week or so, I haven't really been wearing makeup as much because I have been sick. But I literally, like, I wear makeup every day. I wash my face every night. And then I do it all again in the morning. It's just what I like to do. So, hey. But today, I decided that I wanted to try a new face mask. It's supposed to minimize your pores and different things like that. Of course, if you want to look flawless throughout the day, you don't want huge, enormous pores. So I actually looked at Sephora's website and looked at some reviews on this facial mask. I've never tried it before, but I just decided to try it today. The mask, again, is at Sephora, and it is about $8. So the name of this mask is the charcoal mask. I'm not going to lie to y'all, I don't know how to pronounce the name. I don't. To use, open full pack and remove two-piece hydrogel face mask. Unfold face pieces. Bottom piece will be at the top. Remove clear lining from bottom piece. Align and place exposed mask surface directly onto clean, dry face, keeping the white liner in place. Smooth out edges firmly and adjust to contours of face along the jawline. Remove white liner and smooth out air pockets using fingertips. Repeat process with top piece starting at the hairline. Overlapping will occur around the cheek area. Leave on for 20 minutes. Remove mask and discard. Then massage remaining essence in foil pack onto face. So on here it says warning for external use only. I'm trying to understand why they would have to disclose that on a face mask. Like, what else would you use it for? Never mind. I don't even want to know. So, let's get to it. So, I'm about to open it. Okay, that piece doesn't want to come off, so we'll leave it. Hold on. I do have a little bit of makeup on, y'all. I forgot. But I'm going to wash this makeup off, the little bit that I do have on, and then I'm going to use it. Because it's not going to serve any purpose if I have it on top of makeup. So I'm going to wash this off, and I'm going to be right back. Right back. Give me a little while. Don't go anywhere. Y'all better not go nowhere. Matter of fact, while y'all waiting, go off the video and click subscribe if you have not already. But I'll be back. I'm going to wash my face. Okay, y'all. Makeup is gone. I only got a little bit of eyebrows now. No mascara, no nothing. Everything is gone. Just me. So, let's get back to using this mask. The packaging looks odd, but let's see if we can figure it out. Uh, guess this is how my whole face in one package. It looks like it kind of slipped, so it said that the bottom piece will be on top. So this is the bottom piece. And yeah, this is gooey. It's like, not gooey. It's slimy. Yeah. Slimy, slippery. One of those two things, so. Okay, here we go. So this is the mouth part. This is the part that I'm, yes, this is the mask. So this is the part that goes on my face. And it said to leave the white part on, so let's try it. I'm gonna use y'all as my mirror. It's cold. Like, it's in my mouth. I don't wanna taste that. Okay. Come on. Oh my gosh. This is when having acrylic nails gets in the way. We need to peel stuff. Okay. So. Touch firmly. So, yeah. Let's try it again. Okay. Here we go. Is my face like small or something? Like, it's like it's too much mask. It's too much of a extra. Okay, that's smooth. I got that one. Yeah, I'm gonna try to do it a section at a time. What? Did I split my chin? Oh gosh. Okay. I think I ripped the mask, y'all. But we're gonna keep going. Okay. Yeah, it says to get all the. I'm gonna look at the actual mirror. It says to get all the stuff, like the air pockets out, which is what I'm trying to do. Okay. Y'all. I feel like the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I just feel like I just put somebody's face on. That's creepy. Okay. It started caving in on my lip. Like, come on. Okay. Got that part. Got it. Stay there. Don't move. Oh, it's slipping. It's like this will not stay above my lip. Like, what? Okay. There we go. Okay, moving on to the bottom part. I'm scared to talk to y'all because I think it's gonna slide back on my lips. Okay, so this is the top. It's slipping down. This is the part that'll be on my face. This is gonna be so cold. Okay. I'm just peeling it off. And okay. Oh my god, it's so cold. Okay. It won't get off the white paper. I'm gonna have to do it like this. Really? I hope this does not burn if it touches my eye. Maybe that's why I said external use. Maybe we putting it in their eye. I don't know. I still don't understand that part. So, okay. Okay, I think I'm getting it. Oh, I was supposed to start in my forehead first, wasn't I? It did say that on the pack. But I forgot. Why is my lip itching? Because it keeps sliding down. Okay. Yeah, I don't want this on my lips. Like, my lips felt like the itchy scratchy show on my lips. All right. So, ta-da! New face, who this? y'all. I really feel like Jason, I should be on some sort of scary movie, coming to get somebody. This part is driving me nuts. Like, okay. So then, here we go. I'm gonna fix this one more time and then move it along. Okay. Now I feel like a mannequin. I don't know. This thing is giving me all kinds of vibes. Does this change your personality too? Okay. Anyway. So, we're gonna wait 20 minutes is the wait time. And then I will come back and let you guys know what I think about it, how my skin feels, and I'm gonna look with my mirror to see if I notice my pores have gotten noticeably smaller. Great, Chelsea, just stop touching it, y'all. Okay, this is my last time. There, no more touching. Okay, I'll be back in 20 minutes. All right, y'all, so it's been 20 minutes. While waiting, I've noticed, like, here on my forehead, it's not as moist as it was before. It's more, like, rubbery. And here, it kept kind of folding up here and creating those air pockets. I did notice, too, like, I didn't do any talking, but as I was doing things around the house, this part kept dropping down onto my lip, and then the eye part kind of kept coming back up, which under my eyes and above my lip, like every time it does that, it itches like crazy, like under my eyes and above my lip. So I would definitely say I don't want this thing to touch my eyes or my lips, because it's like, oh my God, I got a scratch. I don't know why. I don't know if it's something in it that makes me that way. I don't know. But we are about to remove it. So let's take it off and see how our skin feels. Because also on the packet, it says that I'm supposed to rub any excess into my skin. You're not supposed to wash your face after this. I guess you're supposed to just let it kind of sit overnight. So after I take this off, what I'm going to go ahead and do is take a shower. And after I shower, what I'm going to do is eat and go to bed. So. Let's take this one off one at a time. Starting with the top. Now that it's time to discard it, I figure just like kind of play with it. It's like, it's firm. It's not like easy to rip, can y'all? But you can hear it. It's like squirmy, but it's firm at the same time. So yeah, that's it. And then for the bottom piece, here we go. My face feels really, really cold after taking it off. Y'all, I have a pimple like right under my eye. It's driving me nuts. Like, it's gotta go. It's driving me nuts. Like, for real. I kid you not. But anyway, this is the mouth part. Also sounds really slimy. Okay. Now that we're done destroying that, I'm gonna rub in the excess. Rub it in, rub it in, rub it in. I don't need y'all to comment and tell me that I can't sing. I know I can't. So here's my review or my thoughts about how my skin feels afterwards. So, my skin feels, I want to say, what word am I looking for? Kind of sticky, but not really, if that makes sense. Like, it doesn't feel sticky or gooey like the actual mask felt, but it's like, you can still feel some of the residue even after I've rubbed it in. It still feels a little bit gooey. Not in a bad way, though, so that's a good thing. As far as my pores, let me get my minimizing mirror, and I will tell you if I see a difference in my pores. Let's see. So this is the normal side. All right, so, okay, what I would say about my pores, I had to look one more time, but what I would say about my pores, I would say that they are definitely minimized, so that purpose of the mask has definitely, something on my eye, that part of the mask has definitely been fulfilled. I do think that, like, right around here, and definitely, like, in my nose, so I normally notice my pores standing out the most in my nose and, like, around here. So, I would say that they are definitely minimized. Like, on my face, on my actual, like, my cheeks and like, right in here, I don't see anything. Like, I'll get closer. So, yeah. I would say it served its purpose as far as minimizing my pores. So as far as packaging, I would say that it's packaged okay. And I only say it's packaged okay because I think it has so much of the product on it that it like slips out of these parts that are meant to like help you place it on your face. Outside of that, I think it's packaged fine. Something I did actually see on it, y'all, look. Y'all see this? It's like, you know how if you have a scar or a scratch or something and you put like a gauze on it? It's like gauze right here is what I would describe that as. I don't know if that's to hold it together. So overall, I would say that I really do like the mask because it did leave my face feeling refreshed and it also did minimize my pores. Now I feel like I just want to find a mask by them that's like a minty freshness, you know what I mean? Like after you kind of like just minty freshness, y'all, that's the only way I can describe it. I want to thank y'all for tuning in and joining me and watching my channel. And again, if you have not, go ahead and subscribe, hit that button down there, and share if you care. Thank you again. See you next time. Bye-bye.